In a recent video, we talked about why it's so important to get the value exchange right when trying to build your email list. And we gave four ideas in that video to help you think about how to deliver value. This could be a lead magnet, a mini video course, an email with valuable content, and also discounts. Now today, I'm going to give you the general overview about how you can create the first one, the lead magnet, how you can create a landing page so that people sign up for this, and then how to deliver this to somebody's email automatically. And at the end, I'm going to include a really important part to this, something that not many people do that's going to help you increase your subscriber numbers. My name is Jack from No Code MBA. And if you're new here to the channel, or if you haven't done so already, then please subscribe. And then also check out the description for information on our free guide and also information on how you can access our premium courses. So, a lead magnet. This is usually a PDF which you can deliver automatically to leads, people who want to get access to this in exchange for their email address. So it helps you attract potential customers, and it also fosters customer engagement. And oftentimes, this lead magnet and the landing page that you create is the first impression someone's going to get of you and what you are offering. And in terms of business, this is going to help you capture leads and foster that relationship with them through email. And in another video, we talked about the importance of automation and using email as automation. But just as a quick overview, once you deliver this lead magnet, it doesn't stop there. You can send follow-up automated emails to then take people down a road, sometimes called a sales funnel, in order to lead them to a sale or lead them to whatever it is that you're offering. And again, the lead magnet, the landing page, and the welcome email is that first point of contact for many people when it comes to you and your business and what it is that you're going to offer them. So before we talk about creating the landing page, connecting it to the email service provider and sending that email, let's talk about how to plan your lead magnet. When it comes to creating the lead magnet, it's important to think about what's going to be relevant and valuable to your potential customers. And also, if you can link the lead magnet to what it is that you offer, this adds more to it. So for example, let's say you have a job board website. That is your business. It's for a niche business. And we made a video on this recently about how to create a site like this. Well, for people looking for jobs, you can create a lead magnet that talks about how to land your dream job. It could be a PDF, 6 pages long, with helpful tips and checklists for people when it comes to CVs, their online presence, cover letters, and how to first contact companies. This is relevant to your audience. This is valuable for your audience, and it's going to help people when they come on your job board website. So it's also linked to what it is that you're offering. And when it comes to length, it's not really that important. What's important is what is valuable. Sometimes it can just be a one-page checklist for a specific thing for your industry. Or you could write a mini ebook if that's what you prefer. Maybe 30 pages long that go into depth into one topic that you want to get across to your first-time customers and your leads. And generally speaking, people use a PDF here. But it could be other things as well. Like we talked about in that video, you could create a mini course. You could also do things like webinars to build your audience. But what's important here is that you offer value and you make it relevant to your audience. When it comes to designing the lead magnet, there are many ways to do this now. In fact, AI can do this for you if you want to go down that road. But for most people, they're going to open up Google Docs, going to write their little PDF guide, whatever it's going to be, and then they're going to export this as a PDF. Now, this PDF is then going to live somewhere on the cloud for people to easily download. This could be Dropbox, it could be Google Drive, it could be on your website. So once we have our lead magnet, it's now time to create something very important. In fact, it's one of the most important pages on your website, and it's this, a landing page. Now, a landing page is a standalone page where you're giving people the choice of either getting your lead magnet or not getting your lead magnet. It's a page for action, not for browsing. You're not sending people to your blog to take a look around, to go to the navigation links to maybe click onto your Instagram account, you're stripping all that away and you're saying, listen, this is what I have for you. This is going to be valuable. Do you want this? This is your choice. Because the landing page is all about getting that email to get that new lead. And with that in mind, it's important to really craft that landing page so that you lead people to action. You're going to need a compelling headline that gets their interest, an image that really shows them what's going to happen, to talk about the benefits of getting this lead magnet so that they have a future desired outcome, to build that interest in what you're offering and the desire for it, and then to say, this is the action you need to take. Submit this form, we'll send it to your email address. And there are various website builders that are going to help you do this. Now, there's some standalone software, and I'll link some in the description, where it's all about just crafting landing pages and connecting these landing pages to your website. There are email service providers that offer the ability for you to create a landing page and, again, connect this to your website. We can build a landing page using tools like Card, and I made a video on this fairly recently. You can create your landing page inside Squarespace. You can create a landing page using a template in Webflow. You can create a landing page in WordPress, etc. We're not going to talk about which is the best one in this video. Just know that creating a landing page is going to depend on the website builder that you're using at the moment and also some extra features that you may want down the line too. Okay, so now we have our landing page, which is all about taking action. It's all about saying, hey, this is the action you need to take. This is what we do next. The next step is to connect all of this to your email service provider. And just like we talked about with the landing page, this video isn't about which one to use and how to really get into the details technically, but we're just going to give you an overview in terms of how this process works. And to help you, I'm inside ActiveCampaign, which is the email service provider that I have used. This is going to be fairly similar when you use MailChimp, MailerLite, etc. But the idea here is that I'm setting up a new form where this form is then going to be able to connect to the landing page software. So on this form, we can include different types of fields. Every time it's going to be email. You sometimes want to include the name, first name, full name. These might be required, they might not be. A lot of the time, this design of the form isn't important because the design is going to be on the landing page, and we're just going to use the back end of this form to connect the landing page to your email service provider. But some other things to bear in mind is what list you're going to add them to, if you're going to include any tags on that too, because sometimes you want to tag people to say, this person got this lead magnet, this person signed up to this webinar. So you can integrate all of this inside the email service provider. And then once you've done that, once you've created the form, it's about going to Squarespace, going to Webflow, and following their instructions in order to connect that form to the landing page that you create. So let's just say that you're using Card and you want to connect this to MailChimp. Just search for connect MailChimp to Card and follow their technical instructions, because it's going to be different for every landing page builder and every email service provider. Let's say that you have now connected that form to the landing page that you've designed. You have uploaded your lead magnet. Now it's all about the next step in order to deliver this lead magnet to the person who just put in that email address. And here I am again inside ActiveCampaign, just to show you what it looks like in a general sense. So I'm going to select a trigger, and the trigger is somebody submitting a form. So we click this one here. I'm going to click the test form, add start, and then add the new action, which is to send an email. And I'm going to start with a template, and then this is what we're going to see. So this automation takes place when a contact submits test form. Now we can add new triggers here because we can do things like pop-ups on the website or integrate sign-up forms inside the blog and lots of other things that we can do when people want to get the lead magnet that we have. But what we can see here is that when the contact submits the form, the next step is we're going to send an email. And in that email, this is your welcome email to say, thank you for getting the lead magnet. Here it is. Here are some action steps. This is the first email that you can create in order to have that contact with the new lead, but obviously send them what you said you were going to send them, the lead magnet. And then we're not going to go in depth here, but we can create automations based on this. For example, we can wait for 7 days and send an email. We can wait a day, send them a different email. We can, if they do this, if they click the link, then they can send them to one way, yes, or one way, no. This is like a visual way to look at what happens after somebody becomes a lead. But let's say that you have a premium version of your app for sale. Then what you can do is give them the lead magnet, and then whichever way you want to do it, how salesy you want to be, how strong you want to be in the beginning, when you're going to introduce the premium features depends on you. But the idea is that you're sending emails and send them through this funnel in order to go to that sale. And the beauty of this is that it's just going to do it in an automated way. So when people submit that form on that landing page, then they're going to get that email within 10 seconds, a minute, 2 minutes. So let's say that we have all of that set up. Things are looking good. What can we do next? Well, what I highly recommend here is to test and optimize, to test and optimize. For example, if you have software, a landing page that allows you to do A/B tests, then you can test things like headlines. You can change a headline on one, change a headline on another. You can create different types of concepts for landing pages, so to have completely different landing pages just to see how they do. You can change images, you can change copy, button colors, etc. This is testing things to see which works best, because you might have an idea in mind and a template that you think, okay, people are going to sign up to this form, but your numbers are low. You can then make changes and to see if that makes an improvement. And this is important because you want to have a high conversion rate. You want to have the highest conversion rate that you can get before you put the time and money into getting more traffic to that landing page. But we can also test things inside the email service provider if this is available. And this is something to think about when it comes to finding the right one for you, because we can test things like having different headlines and seeing what the open rates are, different copy and seeing what the click-through rates are, different email automations and seeing what the different sales numbers are. So when you've built this, test and optimize. So those are the steps involved when it comes to creating and delivering a lead magnet to your new lead. We need to make that lead magnet relevant and valuable. We need to then create the lead magnet, upload it to your website, create a landing page, create a form inside the email marketing software, connect this form and software to the landing page, and then deliver it through an automation. And if you want to know the tools available to do this, then definitely check out the description. And while you're in the description, just click the link to the No Code MBA website and get our free guide to no code tools. And if you want to jump right in and go through our premium courses about how to use Glide, how to use Webflow and different apps, then go to our courses page and have a little look around and see if this membership area is going to be valuable for you. And one last thing before you go, please share this video with a friend if you have found it useful. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Speak to you soon. Bye for now.